Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we are going to talk about this crown charm and how to build the surface and also the decoration on the top. Are you ready? Let's get started. Depends on the end goal of what you wanted to do, you may need to consider 3D printing, so you may want to consider the size and printing requirement for your machine, so that way you will make sure you are not making too small or too big or too thick that wastes a lot of money on the material. So first of all, we are coming in with this one, and if you just turn on the control point, you kind of notice there's not much point that you can pull from. So I'm gonna coming over to the top view, we're gonna click on this one, and we want to rebuild this surface. We are going to rebuild have a lot more point, so we have a point we can pull. So I'm going to change to 16 and 7 for U and the V and make sure you keep it degree 3. So now we have this, I'm going to pick up this one, and also the one on the 9 o'clock and the 6 o'clock. And we also wanted to select the whole row. So I'm gonna come over here and using this selection point tool, and we are going to selecting on the V direction. So once you select on the V direction, we are going to use the gumball and to do the 3D scale and have it come back a little bit. So that is the where we can have it caving a little bit. All right, of course on the top we don't want it to have this like pumpkin looking things, so we may want it to have them to coming up. So first of all, I'm coming to the top view and I select everybody. Notice I'm in the wireframe mode right now. And don't forget to deselect the one on the bottom. We just want to deal with the top. The command we are going to use is called set point, and we want to set it with the Z direction at the front view. So now all the point will follow my mouse. Okay, so now we have the top is really nice and rounded. And then by looking at this, if you need to do more adjustment, you can do that. I actually wanted to have them coming up a little bit flat over here. So I'm going to select on this point and go to my selection tool using select V. So the whole row will be selecting, and I wanted this one go down a little bit, and I want to 3D scale up a little bit. So that will giving to whatever shape that you want, and you can keep editing until that you are happy with it. For this demonstration, I'm going to stop it right here. So now this is the shape that we have. The second thing I wanted to do is I need to do those bend on the side. So I'm going to draw a rectangle roughly about here, and we are going to make it a little bit rounded on the corner. So I'm going to use a fitted curve, and I want to set it up for 0.3 here. So I want to click here and also click here. All right. I want this curve to be right in the center. So instead of trying to move it, we are going to use align tool to align vertical center and just type it 0. So this one will be right in the center. Okay. In my design, I also like to make a little groove on the side. So I'm gonna make a circle right there and also mirror to the other side by snapping into the midpoint and select everybody, and let's go ahead to use the trim tool to trim anything in the middle. Alright, and then don't forget to join them. Now once you join it, you want to move it and make sure that it is moving into the position that you want. I actually want them to go a little bit lower. That's roughly where I'm going to cut it and kind of move it to there. Okay, I'm also going to make a copy by bring this one up and rotate it 90 degrees. And we want this one to be right in the center. So I want to move this one up a little bit. So we wanted it to align with our construction plan. So on my front view, I'm going to type it project to C plan. And we want to delete the input. So this guy is going to move it right in the center. And after we get there, we can kind of make them smaller. So if I sweep this to profile, it will get tapered up. All right, so we are ready to sweep. We now have a profile, but we don't have the rail. So let's use extract ISO curve. And we want to extract the ISO curve. If you see ISO curve in this way, all you need to do is come into the top on the option. There's a toggle. You hit on the toggle and you come in back here and then you will see that ISO curve. So I want to have an ISO curve over there. And that way that will for our sweep. Make sure that the sweep direction on your profile is always 90 degrees toward to the rail direction. So I'm going to move it this one, kind of just eyeball it, make sure that it's go 90 degrees toward it. So let's give it a try. We want to use the sweep one rail. This is our rail and we're going to go from here to here. And make sure that they are aligned, right? So I want to align to the corner in this case. And they are facing the same direction, and then we'll get a ribbon looking things right there. Okay, so that's one there. And if that looked nice to you, and then we are going to use this one. Let's go ahead to cap it first to make it into the solid. And we want to come into the top view. Go ahead to use a rotate tool. We want to select this one and make sure the copy on the top right here is equal yes. And the copy center is zero. And we want to hold on the shift key on the keyboard. And so we can make the copy like this. You can also use the polar array, depends on whichever that works for you. Okay, so that looked nice over here. If you look at this and you feel like, okay, you need more bump, you probably want to adjust it right now by turn on the control point and it kind of pull the point up so you can make it more rounded and puffy. Okay, so once you have it like that, we want to have a little bit decoration on the top. So this top, I do want to have like dot, circle dot go all the way to the top. So I'm going to create a UV curve on one of the surface right there. So it give me this area right here, and this area I can arrange some circle over there. So we are gonna come over here on the top view. I'm going to draw some cylinder there. So let's go ahead to use the cylinder, and I'm gonna snapping right at the midpoint, roughly about this size. And how tall is it? Do you want it? It's really up to you, depends on your design. I just kind of eyeball it right there. Okay, to make it really nice on our rendering, I always like to make a little bit fillet. So I want to give it a small fillet, maybe 0.1 only, and let's take a look. All right, so if that look nice to you, we need to make a bunch of them, right? So the command that we are going to use is using the linear array. We're gonna array how many, I'm not sure, but I want more than what I need. So I'm going to type it 12 there. And using this as our guideline, and we can make it over, that's fine, because we can delete them. All right, so now we have this. We are going not need the one close to the edge, maybe going to delete all those three. And we need to flow this back. So first things to do is make them into the surface on that reference surface. So now another thing is we want to make sure to have a successful bowling. Later on, we want to make sure that this one is intersect. So I want to move it down just a little bit to make sure it is intersect. Okay, so now we are ready to flow it back. That's using the command flow along surface, and we're gonna pick up all of the dot we create, and we're gonna pick up one of the edge right there, coming over here to pick up one of the edge right there. So then you will get it flow back in there. Okay, if that looked nice to you, we're going to stay with it. If it is not, you might want to flow again. It's always easier if you have a record history on the bottom so you can adjust it without doing the flow all over. Okay, so now we have this one. All we need to do is selecting all those dots there. Come over here and then select all those dots. And sometimes you might just want to group it, just easier to choose to pick them later on. Alright, so we're gonna use either polar array or rotated with the copy equal yes, and I'm going to use rotated with the copy equal yes to bring those to the top. Alright, so now we are ready to do the bottom one. So the first things to do is I want something as more cushion looking shape. So I'm going to use this rectangle with the corner, snapping into the center. And we're gonna come over something look like this and coming in like that. Let's take a look on this one, and we want to move it down to where we are going to have that seat. All right, so now we have that over there. We want to create some sort of a profile on the bottom, and we can just simply just creating the rectangle right here, and for whatever thickness that you want. And we will also want to giving a radius, and I'm going to set it up for 0.5 and something like this over here. And later I wanted to have a stone right there, so I wanted this one to cave in. We can do is we can explode this one, and with this one that's changing the degree into 5 and 3, and then so we can now moving the point down to kind of a giving a cave in looking, and then that's where we can put the stone there. Okay, so now we have that, or you can simply just create in the arc, depends how you like to do that. Okay, so now I have this and this. I can simply just join it back together. We don't need this inside there unless you want to create some sort of a hollow form, but at this point I'm just gonna create a completely solid form. All right, so now we have that, we just need to sweep into the surface. So this will be my rail, and this is a cross section, and then we can create something like this. Adjust to the height and make sure that fitting into your design. And once you like it, just go ahead and cap it so you will have a solid there. For the rest of it, we will just put a jump ring and make sure that the jump ring is a proper size. You can have a chain or have other jump ring to hook on it, and do a B setting around on the bottom. I have a stone setting course talking about all kind of a stone setting. If you're interested about stone setting, I will have the link in the description below for you to check it out of the course. Thank you for watching. I will see you next.